Dear students, in this video, we are going to study characteristics of a PNP transistor in common emitter configuration. Now, this is the circuit arrangement for finding the static characteristics of PNP transistor in common emitter configuration. Means emitter terminal is common to input base and the output collector terminal. As we can see here, emitter is here common or it is grounded. Now, as we are taking PNP transistor, it is a PNP transistor. Now this is emitter is p-type, base is n-type, collector is p-type. Okay, now if we want the transistor to do its normal function of amplification, then input junction should be forward biased and the output collector junction should be reverse biased. Now, emitter base junction should be forward biased. As emitter is p-type, it should be connected to the positive terminal of the battery. Base is n-type, it should be connected to the negative terminal of the battery. Okay, now here, collector, we need to reverse bias the collector base junction. So if base is negative, okay, which is n-type, if we want to reverse bias, it means P should be more negative than base for the collector base junction to be reverse biased. So collector is also connected to the negative terminal of the battery. This is the biasing arrangement for PNP transistor in common emitter configuration. Here, collector should be more negative than base so that collector base junction should remain in reverse biased. Or we can say that the magnitude of VCC should be greater than the magnitude of VBB so that the collector base junction remains reverse biased. VCC, if we write the KVL equation for the around the loop from this collector through VCC, then VCB, then VBB and then back to collector, then VCC will be equal to VCC will be, or you can say VCC minus VBB is equal to VCB. Okay. Now, this VCC, the magnitude of VCC should be greater than the magnitude of VBB so that this VCB, as VCC is negative, VBB is also negative. Its magnitude, if its magnitude is greater, then VCB will be negative. Okay. Then if VCB is negative, it means collector is more negative than base. So the collector base junction will be reverse, will remain in reversed biased condition. Now we will study the input characteristics of PNP transistor in common emitter configuration. as the emitter base junction is forward biased. Here you can see that milliemitter at the input is replaced by microemitter, because here the input current is base current, and which is very small, it is of order of few microamperes. So we have taken here microampere. Here you can see that this VBB can be varied through this potentiometer R1, VCC can be varied through this potentiometer R2. Here VCE is equal to VCC and VBE is equal to VBB. This is not the practical arrangement, bias arrangement. In practical bias arrangement, we connect external resistors in series with these external voltage sources so that we can control them, we can change their value by changing the value of resistances instead of using these potentiometers. Now, to draw the input characteristics, which is a curve between base current in the range of microampere and base to emitter voltage for a given value of collector to emitter voltage. So first of all, fix the value of VCC. Suppose we have fixed the value of VCC to be minus 2 volt. Now we will increase VBB in small steps and note down the value of the current. We will and then plot them on the graph. Take base current on the vertical axis, VBE on the x-axis. Now we will see that the input characteristics of common emitter configuration will be similar to that of a forward biased diode, which states that for a small change in voltage there is large change in current. Okay, now what happens when VCE is increased, when the magnitude of VCE is increased from 2 volt to 6 volt, what will happen? Will the curve shift to right or will the curve shift to left? Will it become a good diode or will it become a bad diode? Now, as we can see from these curves, that for a given value of, for a given value of VBE, when the VCE is increased, base current reduces, so it will become a bad diode. The curve shifts to the right when VCE is increased. Okay, now here, now we will change this setting of VCC through this R2, change its value to 6 volt, and the curve will shift to the right. For a given value of base to emitter voltage, base current reduces because of early effect, or you can say base width modulation. What happens when the reverse bias voltage between collector and emitter is increased? The depletion layer width increases in the collector emitter at the collector emitter junction. Now, as the base is lightly doped, the depletion layer penetrates deeper into the base region. This will reduce the effective base width, and there will be less chances of recombination of injected carriers within the base region. So base current will be reduced. So we can say here, as we can see here, the base current will be reduced when VCE is, the magnitude of VCE is increased. Now what about the transistor, common emitter transistor dynamic input resistance? So as you can see, the dynamic input resistance is equal to change in VBE divided by change in IB for a given value of, or a fixed value of VCE. Now here we can see, as in common base configuration, in Dynamic input resistance was given by delta VEB over delta IE. So numerators are same in both the cases, but denominator here is IB, which is of range of few microamperes. So the dynamic input resistance of common emitter configuration is not very low. Okay, because IB is in the range of few microamperes. So the dynamic input resistance of a common emitter configuration ranges from 800 ohm to 3 kilo ohm, and its typical value is 1 kilo ohm. This is about the input common emitter characteristics. Now we will study the output characteristics. Okay, this is the output characteristics of a common emitter PNP transistor. Again, it is showing three regions of operation: active region, when the emitter base junction is forward biased, and when the collector base junction is reverse biased. Now, as we can see here, that we will plot collector current for variation in collector to emitter voltage for different fixed values of IB. First of all, we will fix one value of IB. Suppose, let's say, we will change VBB so that this emitter, micro emitter, reads equal to 10 micro ampere. So here, now base current is fixed. Now we will increase VCC, which is equal to VCE in our case, in small steps, and observe the reading of this emitter to plot the IC versus VCE. Now, as we can see, that when VCE is increased, then when the transistor is operating in the active region, then IC is IC collector current is approximately equal to beta IB. And if we want to find the beta, the beta of a common emitter configuration ranges from 20 to 300, and its typical value is 100 to 150. Let's say the beta of this transistor is 110, so that if IB is minus 10 microampere, then IC will be equal to minus 110 microampere, or you can say that minus 1 milliampere, minus 110 divided 110 multiplied by divided by 1000. So if it is 10, if you multiply 110 by 10, it will be 1100. When you divide it, it will become 1.1. So it is equal to 1.1 milliampere. So when the base current is minus 10 microampere, collector current is minus 1 milliampere. And we can see here the curve rises more rapidly to the right in the case of common emitter configuration. It is not that horizontal as was the case in the common base configuration. So that we can say that for a given change in VCE, there is appreciable change in, you can say, कलेक्टर करंट डेल्टा आई सी, दिस इज डेल्टा वी सी ई. सो कर्व इज नॉट दैट हॉरिजॉन्टल, सो दैट वी कैन से दैट आउटपुट रेजिस्टेंस, डायनेमिक आउटपुट रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ कॉमन एमिटर कॉन्फिग्रेशन इज नॉट वेरी हाई. ओके, इट इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा वी सी ई ओवर डेल्टा आई सी एट कॉन्स्टेंट आई बी. आई बी इज कॉन्स्टेंट, कॉन्स्टेंट. ओके, as for given change in VC there is appreciable change in collector current, so its output resistance is not very high, it is in the range of output resistance of common emitter is in the range of 20, it is typical value is equal to 25 kilo ohm, or you can say that it is in the range of kilo ohm and not in, it is of the order of kilo ohms and not the mega ohms as was in the case of common base configuration. Now, okay, this is about active region. Now, what happens when VCE is reduced below few tenths of a volt? Now here VCE, if you write the general equation, VCE is equal to VCB plus VBE. Now VBE, as the emitter base junction is forward biased, so VBE is constrained to 0.7 volt. Now when VCE is reduced below, you can say when VCE is reduced below few tenths of a volt, suppose when VCE becomes equal to VBE, here VCE becomes equal to minus 0.7 is equal to VCB, VB is also equal to minus 0.7 for NPN transistor. So VCB becomes equal to 0, which means collector base junction is no longer reverse biased. So when the VCE is reduced below 0.3, when the magnitude of VCE is reduced below 0.3, say it becomes minus 0.2, it is equal to VCB minus 0.7, so that VCB becomes equal to 0.7 minus 0.2, or you can say 0.5 volt. This will make the collector base junction well in the forward bias state, because now this becomes positive, which means that collector, or you can say P, is more positive than base, or you can say N. When P, or you can say anode, is more positive than cathode, then the junction is forward bias. So now the collector base junction is well in forward bias state, and we can say this is the saturation here. Now the transistor will operate in the saturation region, where it will behave as an open switch. So this is the saturation region. When the collector to emitter voltage is reduced below the few tenths of a volt, or it is reduced to around 0.2 volt or 0.3 volt, then collector current decreases sharply, because now collector base junction is forward biased. Both the junction input and output will be forward biased, so the collector current decreases very sharply. Okay, now we will discuss about the cutoff region. When the base current is zero, even then there will be very small amount of collector current flowing through the collector, and this is nothing but the reverse leakage current, collector to emitter reverse leakage current with the base terminal open, ICEO, ICEO. So the curve is very near to origin but not zero. So when IB is zero, collector current is not zero, it is equal to ICEO. Now, and this region is called as cutoff region, where both the junctions become reverse biased and the transistor can be operated in as off switch in this cutoff region. Now we have talked about output resistance. Now we will see how we can find out the current gain, beta, common emitter current gain. Suppose this is the characteristic curve which is given to us. Suppose if we want that the operating collector to emitter voltage is 10 volt, okay, then draw the vertical line, and we want the what will be the value of collector current when the base current is equal to 30 microampere. So draw a vertical line, okay, extend it backward, and the point of intersection of the characteristic curve for IB is 30 microampere, and this vertical line will give you the operating point. So now extend a vertical line or perpendicular line or vertical axis, this will give you the value of IC. Suppose IC comes out to be 3.6, or 3. The current comes out to be 3.6 milliampere. Now output resistance will be delta VCE over delta IC for IB is 30 microampere. Okay, so these two lines, delta VCE and delta IC, this will give us 25 kilo ohm. Now if you want to find the beta DC, we will find at the point when the VCE is equal to 10 volts. So at that point, for 30 microampere, the value of IC is around 3.6 milliampere. We had just calculated. So beta DC is IC by IB, 3.6 milliampere over 30 microampere. So beta DC comes out to be 120. This is the typical value of beta. Now, if we want to calculate the AC current gain, it is given by delta IC over delta IB for a constant value of VCE. So now here delta VCE, suppose voltage changes from, I can say, delta IC over delta IB. Okay. Now base current, when the base current changes from 30 microampere to 40 microampere, what will be the change? Now you will extend this vertical line up to 40 microampere, and the point where it intersects, draw a vertical line on the perpendicular line on the to the vertical axis. This will give you the value of collector current at 40 microampere. This point will give you the value of collector current at 30 microampere. So that beta AC comes out to be 4.7 milliampere minus 3.6 milliampere divided by 40 microampere minus 30 microampere. So beta AC comes out to be 110. The current gain of common emitter configuration is very large. When alpha approaches unity, beta approaches infinity. For a small change in alpha, there will be a large change in beta. Okay, this is all for today's lecture. Thank you so much.